Okay, then we will start. This is one of the interesting topic, Kanban. Okay, so
I have one question, Bhaskar.
yeah, Bhaskar, go ahead.
We had a discussion about batch determination, automatic or as well. But is it also possible to have a scenario of discuss backflush automatically with this batch determination process?
I think we okay. So we already discussed about the backflush. Okay, so you want to know, like, let's say we are working on a repetitive manufacturing, right? And for the repetitive manufacturing for the component, automatic batch determination has to happen. That's what you are thinking, right? Let's say,
And if it's for discrete
or
as well?
yeah, it's for discrete as well. So I guess that will be the good homework for you. If you could go and start configuring, it will exactly work in the same fashion. But still, if you want, I will again, create some
I would like to just
example.
ask you, there is one transaction OBJ2, OBJ2, if you can open for me and then can explain me that customizing. That's a customizing screen.
Okay, that's fine. We'll check. What is that? OP J?
OB, no, so I think it's
OB
OBZ, jet, OBZ,
J or Z? OBJ
2.
2. OBJ 2. So
I hope
this
it's correct.
this one? No, no, no. No, this one? No.
It's under availability,
Okay.
where we have a batch. Something stock automatic goods. Wait, let me also check in my system.
This is batch determination at the time of goods issue that will be working based on your movement type. So you need to activate that for 261 movement type so that automatically batch will get determination and backflush for your production order. Maybe that's what. Okay, anyway, I need to find out, but we will discuss it later, if after this session, maybe. Okay, is that okay?
Okay, yeah, no problem. Meanwhile, I will also find the transaction code. Okay.
Yes. Or also, I'll try to create one quick scenario for that, and I'll try to showcase this thing.
Thank you very much.
Okay? Yes.
Good. Yeah. Hey, hi, Pankaj. This is Ankit.
Yeah, Ankit.
So I was going through the videos which you have uploaded on the portal because I have recently joined. So I was going through that planned order scenarios, and I figure it out, like, when we create the planned order and once you do a confirmation MFBF, the good issue and good receipt used to take place.
Yeah,
but I have not seen any confirmation number used to get generate, or I can see the confirmation in AFRU table or somewhere. So how someone will know whether the confirmation took place for that particular planned order or not?
Yeah, Ankit, so basically, for the repetitive manufacturing, when we are doing the confirmation, that will definitely, not go to AFRU table. But somehow in the back end, there is always a production order, right? One internal order. And against that, your activity types and everything will get backflash. For that, there are some separate reports available, okay, from where you can see. Let me check. MF 13, I guess. Oh, sorry. Let me check. MF42.
But it's always about good issue and good receipt, and there should not be
activity.
Any
yeah. There will be the activity also. We are posting the activity also in MFBF, right?
Okay. Because in MFBF, when I was seeing, there were three options, like somewhere it was
assembly, saying, component, and activity.
Yeah.
Right?
So which one is the correct one? Like.
So normally, see, when you are saying it's my continuous production, right? So ultimately, you want to post your goods issue as well as good receipt as well as your activity, right? So assembly backflush is the right option to go ahead. Otherwise, you can just do the component posting, and again you are coming back for the activity. That will not be the right option to go ahead, right?
Okay,
so we were choosing assembly backflush for that. So that what happened for that specific assembly, whatever the components required, that will get backflush. At the same time, whatever the activity that required, that will also get posted, right? So there is a transaction. Let me check. Or I'll provide that information to you also separately. Okay, repetitive production planning. And
the Bhaskar provided in the window OPJ2.
OPJ2.
No, that is for me, for the
no, that is different. Scenario. Okay. Goods movement for the batch determination. That's what we are talking about, Bhaskar. OPJ2. Okay.
And Pankaj, while I was creating the plan order, I found like I can only see the component material and a production version. Now in the same scenario, when we talk about the production order, I can see the operations which are assigned to particular production order. But in plan order, I cannot see the operation because I need to go into the rate routing. Yeah. So I cannot see those operation in
that will be always there. Since see, when you are creating any plan order, that will be with reference to the production version, correct? And that correct. Production order will always have one bill of material and one routing.
Yeah, production version do have a bill of material routing, and I can see the operations assigned in the production version itself.
Okay, let me see. I'll see the material which we have created, whether that is REM, this one. I don't know if there plan orders are there. Yeah, there are some plan orders, right? So you are saying when you are going here, you are not able to see the operations. Now let's say here is the component that I can easily see, but here is the master data. In that master data, you have a detailed scheduling routing captured here, right? So for that plan order, what is the detail captured here? You can simply double click and you can see these are the operations assigned for that.
Okay. And if we want to change the operation, like if I need to change, so I need to use PP03 key. So I need to change the entire rate routing change
it? No. See, basically the repetitive manufacturing scenario itself saying, okay, when we are having the continuous set of operations, and the standard sequence of operation that is not supposed to change for a longer period of time, in that case, you can use this. If you have alternative sequence or parallel sequence for any continuously changing in the operation for the specific plan order, you should go with the discrete manufacturing, right? So still you are saying now, let's say this is my master data, right? And here I can see the component and everything, and you want to change the routing. That's what system is saying. In case of repetitive manufacturing, you are not allowed to go and do the changes over there, right?
Okay,
so if you are changing, for the specific plan order, you are not supposed to change it. But in future, let's say you are changing everything, right? You can simply go to CA22.
Then I need to change the complete master data. So it's not like production order where I can directly go in order and change the
routing. That's what discrete manufacturing is.
Got it, sir. And only the
confirmation part.
Only the confirmation part. Like when I go into MFBF.
Let me check.
Sure.
Okay, sir. I'll play the transaction here, MFBF. Okay. And here is the assembly component and activity, right? So we are actually choosing assembly backflush, right? When I'm going here, just a minute, let's see. Okay. Now, if you are going here, you will be able to see the components and everything. This is the activity backflush. Here you will be able to see what are the different activities you are supposed to use it there, right? So let me check.
But sir,
these are the activity. Both things will be there. When you are doing the backflush at the activity level, you will be able to see this is the work center, and in that work center you are having one activity no activity backflush for that operation selected. Okay, so I'm selecting it and I can go ahead and complete the activity for that operation. Now I will show you for the assembly one. That's what we were talking. Do you want to terminate? Yes. Okay. Let's say, just try to find out the difference. Okay.